I welcome you all for class 9 subject science. So we will continue on topic, that is tissues. Here we are going to learn the next type of tissue, that is connective tissue. Blood is a type of connective tissue. Why could it be called connective tissue? Yes, why? Because it connects from one part of the body to the other. Blood is moving from the head to the toe. So it is known as connective tissue. The cells of connective tissue are loosely spaced and embedded in an intercellular matrix. The matrix may be jelly-like fluid, dense or rigid. The nature of matrix differ in concordance with the function of a particular connective tissue. Example, take a drop of blood on a slide and observe different cells present in it under a microscope. As you can see in the picture, this you can be observed in the microscope. What can you see now? Blood has a fluid matrix. Fluid means nothing but the liquid matrix called plasma. You can see the fluid like matrix is present. Then blood contains mainly red blood cells, RBCs, then white blood cells, WBCs, and platelets are suspended. The plasma contains protein, salts and hormones. Blood flows and transports gases, digested food, hormones and waste material to different parts of the body. What is the function of the blood? It transports gases, then digested food, hormones and waste material to different parts of the body. Another example for the connective tissue is the bone. It forms the framework that supports the body. Okay, this is the picture of the bone cell which you can see in the figure. It forms the framework that supports the body. It also anchors the muscles. Anchors the muscles means the muscles are attached to the bones and supports the main organs of the body. It is a strong and non-flexible tissue. How the bones are? Bones are flexible? No, it is strong. The advantage of this property is for bone. Bone cells are embedded in a hard matrix. How it is, means the cell, why it is hard? Because it has a embedded hard matrix that is composed of calcium and phosphorus compounds. Bone contains calcium and phosphorus compounds, therefore it is hard. It can be asked why the bones are hard, what it consists of, why it is hard, means you should write there. Because of the presence of calcium and phosphorus, the bone cells are hard. Two bones can be connected to each other by another type of connective tissue called the ligament. This tissue is very elastic. It has considerable strength. Ligaments contain very little matrix. Tendons connect muscle to bones and another type of connective tissue. Tendons are another type of connective tissue. Ligaments are different type. Which are the types now we are learning? First was the blood. Second is the bone. The third I told you was the ligament. Now the fourth one we are talking about tendons. Tendons connect muscle to the bones and are another type of connective tissue. Tendons are fibrous tissue with great strength but limited flexibility. Another type of connective tissue are cartilage. Here in this picture you can see the different types of connective tissue. Ligaments you can see, cartilage you can see. These are the ligaments, these are the cartilage, right? And this is the bone, the hard part. And then this is nothing but the fluid which is contained between the two bones. The cartilage is another type of connective tissue. The solid matrix is composed of proteins and sugar. Cartilage smoothens both bone surface and joints and is also present in the nose, ear, trachea and larynx. We can fold the cartilage of the ears but we cannot bend the bones in our arms. Right, this is because of the cartilage. As you can see in the picture, in between of two bones, that is the cartilage is present. The next is the areolar connective tissue is found between, these are the areolar connective tissue found between the skin and the muscle, around blood vessels and nerves and in the bone marrow. It fills the space inside the organ, support internal organ and helps in the repair of tissues. These are nothing but the areolar tissue. The next type is the adipose tissue. Fat storing tissues are nothing but the adipose tissue, where the fats are stored in our body, means in the adipose tissue, and is found below the skin and between the internal organs. Where is it stored? Between the skin and the internal organs. What is stored? Adipose tissue. In adipose tissue, what is there? It is filled with the fat. The cell of these tissues are filled with fat globules. Storage of fat also let it act as an insulator. Understood? Is it clear? Okay. The next type of tissues are the muscular tissue. Muscular tissue consists of elongated cells and also called muscle fibers. This tissue is responsible for movement in our body. Muscle contains special proteins called contractile proteins, which contract and relax to cause movement. As I said earlier, that movement of breathing is because of the muscles. Now same here also the process goes on, that is the muscular tissue. There are three types of muscular tissue. We can move some muscle by conscious will. Yes or no? Our hands, legs and all in our control. That is known as voluntary muscles. Which are not in our control are known as involuntary muscles. The muscles are called skeletal muscles as they are mostly attached to the bones and help in the body movement. Under the microscope, you can see how it is there. These muscles slow alternate light and dark bands or striation with strain approximately. As a result, they are called striated muscles. Just because of the design, they have given different names for that. The first one, what you can see, is the striated muscle. These striated muscles are tissue are long, cylindrical, unbranched and multinucleated, having many nuclei. Multinucleated means many nuclei. It is long, it is like a cylinder, it is like you can see in the picture how it is. So this is nothing but the what type of muscle fiber? Striated muscle fiber. The next is the involuntary. Right, involuntary, the movement of foot in the alimentary canal or the contraction and relaxation of the blood vessel are involuntary movements. That is not in our control. It goes on with itself. That is known as involuntary movement. We cannot really start them or stop them by wanting to do. Smooth muscles or involuntary muscles such movements. They are also found in the iris of the eye, in uterus and in the bronchi of the lungs. The cells are long with pointed ends, spindle shape. You can see the second here picture. It is spindle shape and uninucleated, having a single nucleus. Uninucleated means only one nucleus is present. They are also called unstriated muscles. The other type of muscle is the cardiac muscle. The muscle of the heart show rhythmic contraction and relaxation throughout life. These involuntary muscles are called cardiac muscle. Heart muscles cells are cylindrical, branch and uninucleated. How they are the design it is? It is cylindrical, branch also and single nucleus is present in it. Compare the structures of different types of muscular tissue. Means different type of muscular tissue does the different function in our body. The next here is the nervous tissue. Cells of the nervous tissues are highly specialized for being stimulated and then transmitting the stimulus very rapidly. What is the meaning of nervous tissue? When you feel hot or cold, how you will know? Because of the nervous system. You feel, the feeling comes through the nervous system. So it should be very fast. Yes or no? If it is not fast, then your hands will be burnt. Till it goes the message to your brain and come back, the hands or the leg is burnt there. So it is very quick and rapid from one place to another within the body. What are the now, which are the part of the nervous tissues are? The brain, spinal cord and nerves are all composed of the nervous tissue. The cell of these tissues are called nerve cells or neuron. What type of cells are present? Neurons are present in the nervous tissue. A neuron consists of a cell body. As you can see in the picture, this is the figure of a neuron. A neuron consists of a cell body with the nucleus and cytoplasm. You can see here, this is the cell body and it is cytoplasm is present in that. From which long, thin, hair-like part arises. Usually, each neuron has a single long part. This long part is known as the axon and many short branched parts called dendrites. So these parts, the hair-like projections are the dendrites. An individual nerve cell may be up to a meter long, means one cell will be 1 meter long. You know meter, how much it is? 100 centimeter is equals to 1 meter. Like that, a nerve cell will be 1 meter long. Many nerve fibers bound together by connective tissue make up a nerve. Means what? Nerves, where are the nerves present? Nerves are present in the whole of the body. Yes or no? From the hair till the toe, you have the sense. That is because of the this nervous system. Wherever you touch or you can, when you remove one hair, you feel, right? That is because of the nervous system. Nerve impulses allow us to move or our muscle when we want. What is the function? It helps us to move our muscle when we want. The functional combination of nerve and muscle tissue is fundamental to most animals. This combination enables animal to move rapidly in response to stimuli. This is nothing but whenever we want, we can move, or whenever it is a danger, we can run from there, or we can remove our hand. That is because of the nervous system. This completes the chapter. You have to complete all the question answers which are given in between of the text in the classroom. Thank you.